جوز وعمه للشيخ صالح عثيمين. الله يبارك فيك. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، وصلى الله وسلم على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وبعد. We first start thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for allowing us to be from those who Allah jalla wa ala has favored to start the month of Ramadan. And we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is deserving to be thanked, for indeed thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is sababun li ziyada fi ni'am, for indeed being grateful to Allah, thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is one of the means of having your favors increased by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. كما قال تعالى وإذ أذن ربكم لئن شكرتم لأزيدنكم. Remember when your Lord proclaimed that if you are grateful to Allah, لأزيدنكم, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will increase you. So from the means of seeing oneself increased, it is that, alhamdulillah, first and foremost, one is to be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we thank Allah Jalla wa Ala for all His favors upon us. And it is of a great favor that, alhamdulillah, we all sitting around in the masjid waiting for the Salatul Isha. For indeed, the person that is waiting for another Salah in the masjid, كَأَنَّهُ فِي الصَّلَاةِ, he is as if he is in Salah, مَا لَمْ يُحْدِثْ, as long as he is not breaking his wudu. So this is a favor from that. And also, alhamdulillah, being able to see our children being in the circles, in the masjid, understanding the importance of the fasting. And what even, alhamdulillah, seeing them at very young ages, alhamdulillah, having their desire of fasting, having the desire of standing in the Taraweeh. I mean, this is something that one has to be thankful to Allah, to see kids 7 years old, 6 years old, all the way up, alhamdulillah, being in the ranks, right? In the whole Salawat, in the whole Taraweeh, as their fathers or their mothers. This is something that one has to be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Bi-ithnillahi ta'ala, what we will embark upon doing is from Monday to Thursday in the month of Ramadan, we will be reading, insha'Allah ta'ala, from the Juz Amma, the tafsir of Juz Amma by Shaykh Salih Al Uthaymeen, and also other tafsir in regard to the same Juz. And this is, alhamdulillah, that the short surah, short for lack of a better term, that we all memorize. It is important that, alhamdulillah, one understand what is the meaning of what he is reciting. As we mentioned, alhamdulillah, anybody been praying for a long time behind the imam, perhaps never heard the imam made a mistake in a Fatiha. Right? Adam, have you ever recalled the imam skipping a verse in the Fatiha? Very rarely. Or even yourself, have you ever recalled making a mistake on the Fatiha? And this is the verse, a surah, that, alhamdulillah, all the Muslims will say memorized. But not all the Muslims understand what they recite in Surah Al-Fatiha. Right? Not all the Muslims understand the meaning of Surah Al-Fatiha. So, alhamdulillah, as this was done previously during the course of our Ustaz Jazahullah Khaira in the meaning of Surah Al-Fatiha, we're going to embark upon that also, starting with that bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. So the sitting of our jalsa, alhamdulillah, will be a good 20 minutes or whatnot, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala, while we're waiting for the Salatul Isha and the Salatul Taraweeh. Sheikh Saleh Al-Uthaymeen rahimahullah, he first start by saying summiya bidhalika, meaning Surah Al-Fatiha. He says summiya bidhalika li'annahu iftataha biha al-Qur'an al-Karim. He says it is called Fatiha because it opens, or it is the opening of the Qur'an. It is the opening of the Qur'an, meaning the introduction, right? The opening, that which introduce, or that which come before, or the first thing that comes. وَقَدْ قِيلَ, and it is also said, إِنَّهَا أَوَّلُ سُورَةٌ نَزَلَتْ كَامِلَةً. And also it is said that it is the first surah that was revealed, all of it at one point. Meaning the first surah to be revealed in its completion, it is Suratul Fatiha. The first surah that was revealed, right, in its completion is called Suratul Fatiha. He say, هذه السورة, this surah, قال العلماء, the scholars of tafsir, they say, إنها تشتمل على مجمل معاني القرآن في التوحيد. That the Suratul Fatiha, it comprises all of the meaning of the Quran in regard to the Tawheed. Meaning the Suratul Fatiha, it is the meaning of all of the Tawheed. Or if you want a synopsis, meaning a brief summary of Tawheed, it is in Suratul Fatiha. Meaning all aspects of Tawheed you will find in Suratul Fatiha. All the different types of Tawheed, you will find it in details, walillah alhamdu wal min, in regard to the Suratul Fatiha. And likewise, wal ahkam, and the rulings also. Wal jaza, and likewise, you will find the ruling in Al-Fatiha. And also you will find, barakallahu fikum, the reward in Al-Fatiha. My question would be, the ahkam, the rulings, where do we find it in Surah Al-Fatiha? If I were to ask, okay, where do we find Tawheed in Fatiha? It's easy. All of us would understand it. Right? Also, where do we find Al-Jaza, the reward, in Surah Al-Fatiha? It is in it. But how about Al-Ahkam, the rulings? Where do we find it in Al-Fatiha? Where do we find the ruling in Fatiha? The ruling. No. Al-Ahkam. Ahkam al-Din. The ruling. When a person say, Iyaka na'budu wa Iyaka nasta'in, that also shows that what is the ruling of the ibadah, it is only for Allah. The ruling of the ibadah, it is only for Allah. Because you say, Iyaka na'budu wa Iyaka nasta'in. So the ruling of the worship, it is to be directed only to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As al-jaza, when we say Maliki Yawmiddin, this is barakallahu fikum, to show that there is no one that will reward Yawm al-Qiyamah except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is the owner of the day of recompense. He is the owner of the day of reward, right? So he mentioned, so therefore Surah Al-Fatiha deal with this issue, Tawheed, Ahkam, and likewise Al-Jaza. He say, وَطَرِقَ بَنِي آدَمَ, and likewise, Allahu Akbar, likewise the different ways of the people, of the children of Adam. The different ways of the children of Adam. Right? The different ways of the children of Adam. The children of Adam, they are of three types. Those who have earned the anger of Allah. Those who are upon misguidance, meaning they are doing actions without no knowledge. And the third one are those, الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ, those that Allah has bestowed upon them His favors. These are the three different type of people from the turuq of Bani Adam, the different ways of the children of Adam. So either the person, he is being bestowed upon him the favors of Allah, or he earned the anger of Allah, or he is someone that is out of misguidance. He is someone that is غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين, no, those who are astray. So these are, barakallahu fikum, the turuq, the different route or the different path that the human, the son of Adam, barakallahu fikum, is embarking upon. He say, wa ghayri dhalik, and other than that, in that you can find in Surah Al-Fatiha. Wa li dhalika summiya, and this is why it is called Ummul Qur'an. Ummul Qur'an. This is why it is called Ummul Qur'an. And you all remember in Ummul Qura, limada Ummul Qura, because Mecca is called Ummul Qura. Why? Right, it is the returning point for all other cities. It is a returning point for all other cities. So here, Ummul Qur'an, لِذَٰلِكَ سُمِّيَتْ. This is why Surah Al-Qur'an, I mean Surah Al-Fatiha is Ummul Qur'an. لِمَاذَا? He say, because وَالْمَرْجِعُ لِلشَّيْءِ يُسَمَّى أُمَّنْ. So whatever, if there is one thing that it is always returning to, this is what is called Al-Umm. This is what is called Al-Umm. Right? And picture, barakallahu fikum, a baby.